way longer than what I wanted it to.
Mr. Toad?
Do something, Bigby, before he completely tears up the place!
Whoa, 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 hey!
You've got something on your face.
Fuck are you talking about, you stupid cunt?
You're not as bad as everyone says you are.
Please, Bigby, promise me you won't tell Beast you saw me.
I promise.
I'm staying out of it.
Thank you for trusting me.
Have you seen my wife? Have you seen Beauty?
Come with me.
Don't interrupt me, Miss Snow!
You asked me a question.
Don't change the subject. You are to blame for this unpleasantness, Miss Snow.
No, I'm Dee. He's dumb.
But he said if all of this ever got back to him, if he ever thought you knew, or Miss White, he'd come back and kill my boy.
I'm looking for the woodsman.
Well, he's not here.
Holly, you're out of paper towels and...
Oh, look, he's here.
They're gonna string me up, Bigby. That it looks fucking bad. It looks really bad, but I didn't do it.
All right. I got $100 for the first bloke that could tell me something about a girl named...
Fuck, man!
This fucking lab dog. He comes sniffing around this place. Rich fucks in the woods need to shake down. Ain't that right, Bigby?
Now things are worse off than they've ever been.
Well, that's not true.
Right. We've had it worse. Much.
Yeah, so you're dead. So it's pretty fucking worse. What? It's all pixelated there.
Yeah, pixels.
You're making this more difficult than it has to be. If you just cooperate and answer the questions, you can go home. Maybe get some sleep.
I haven't slept in 2 days.
How are you feeling?
I'm fine.
I know it's been a long night for you. You look like you could use some rest.
I'll be better when I find who did this, which I can't do while sitting in here.
We all want the same thing here, Bigby. Look, I know what you must be going through.
Do you?
Really, I do. But I could use your cooperation. That's very helpful. Thank you.
You're welcome. You're writing that down? He took a smoke? I wonder if I said fuck off. Would she write that too? Fuck off. Say.
I'm Detective Brannigan.
What?
Do you hear that?
No.
Please. Please. I'm sorry. Just make it stop. Please.
I didn't do it.
We have to go now.
What are you doing here?
You should be thanking me.
No.
It's just a memory wipe spell. Very expensive.
but it works. The whole station will forget the last 24 hours and everything they saw at the Woodlands. Well, hurry up.
Actually, I was enjoying our quality time before that brain aneurysm hit her. I'll be taking that. Shit.
Thanks for bailing me out.
Certainly. We found Tweedledee chained up to a post. That was your doing, correct?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, I don't know why you detained him. Dee was at the trip trap when Snow was left at the Woodlands, so he couldn't possibly be involved in this mayhem. Bluebeard's currently interrogating him.
He's working for somebody. And whoever it is wants him snooping around every crime scene I've looked at.
That doesn't necessarily mean they're involved in the murders. I know what you're thinking, Bigby. It's been one full night and a slice of morning. And I already miss her, too. You know, I never get more homesick than when one of us dies. And now, were it to be Snow, I've never been good with these sorts of things. I just can't believe this is really happening.
Give me a fucking break.
What?
You treated her like the fucking maid, and now? You want a shoulder to cry on? You didn't care then, and you don't care now.
That is not true. Not true at all. I thought we had some common ground, could discuss this like gentlemen.
Let's get something straight here, all right? We have exactly nothing in common. Everything that connects us is dead and gone.
I don't know why I'm asking you, but did she give any indication as to what she was thinking? When you saw her last, I mean. I don't know why, but I'd like to know that she was... I guess fine, I suppose.
She could come off as callous sometimes, but she wasn't really. She said that she wanted to change things, make it easier for Fables to get help when they need it.
I don't know what else to say, Bigby. We have to put an end to this. It's been two murders in as many days. If we don't unearth our culprit, and soon, there will likely be another on our doorstep tonight.
I'll get it done.
Please, Bigby, for Miss White.
I got it.
You're pushing it.
That's not a very good answer, is it?
Come on, just tell me what I want to know.
It will make things a lot less painful for you, in theory.
Oh, were you planning on using that? I just thought you really liked rubbing your little sword.
That means two things.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
Hello, Ichabod. Sheriff.
At ease.
Bluebeard.
I was just chatting with our new friend.
You were supposed to wait for us to get back. I told you, if you want to be involved, you will do things my way.
Oh, wait, I see the shade.
No violence.
Of blued. Blue, not blue.
Whatever you say, Ichabod.
Hello, Bigby.
I want answers, D.
Oh, goody. I thought you wanted questions, and I was having so much trouble thinking of any good ones. Though I'd settled on, how's your head?
You see what I've been dealing with? What are you going to do about this, Bigby?
It's been better, but we're not here to talk about me. Snow White is dead.
Look, I didn't kill anyone.
And I'm supposed to just believe you.
You were with me when it happened, dummy.
I'm gonna enjoy this.
I still have questions for you, Dee.
Sounds like a personal problem.
This is ridiculous.
Let him work. He's got more experience with these kinds of things.
You know I saw you at Faith's apartment. What were you doing there?
Girl's got air conditioning. You can't imagine what it's like.
All right, Dee. Let's get to know each other.
Yeah.
Fuck, Bigby. Don't make me look at that. Just put that away. Please.
Snow was murdered, Dee. She was important to me. If you know who did this, you have to tell me.
I don't know what to tell you. You're barking up the wrong tree. I don't know who did it.
Okay. Okay, you want to make things complicated? Let's make things
just complicated. Just tell me what you were doing at Faith's apartment.
Look, Bigby, we're not on opposite sides here. My brother and I are trying to get to the bottom of things. Same as you.
Okay.
Your brother. Where was he last night?
I can't say. He could have been anywhere.
Take your best guess.
He didn't do it, if that's what you're thinking.
Then where is he?
No, I'm not sending you after my brother. Look, I answered your question. Can I get my stuff back now?
What did you find on him?
Oh, nothing of consequence, really.
You always carry this much cash?
I've got a lot of laundry to do this week. What's it to you?
I'm taking it.
I'm declaring a tax on uncooperative troublemakers.
You taken out a loan? You might not like the interest on that.
You'll need to account for that. You can't just... There are procedures to be followed. We'll talk about it later.
Walk away.
So where's your brother?
Look, mate, I'd like to help. I would, but I can't tell you where he is. Last time I saw him, we split up and I went to find Faith. I don't know where he is now, but he didn't kill anybody.
You mentioned Faith?
Look... I went to her apartment. That's no secret. You saw me.
No, there's more to it. You said you were trying to find something.
All right, Dee. Since you never answered my first question, what did you want from Faith?
Sorry, I can't help you. I'm not saying any more about it.
Okay, let's see.
You just carry this around?
Always handy that way. What the fuck? Bigby, you shit! So, this is how it's gonna be.
What are you doing?
Getting answers.
I told you to keep yourself under control.
Let me handle this. What did you want from Faith?
I didn't want shit from that little thief. More trouble than she's worth.
I could say the same about you.
Oh yeah? Untie me and see how much trouble I am.
She stole from you?
She didn't steal anything from me, jackass. It was from my boss. You think I got anything worth stealing?
Your boss.
So let's talk about your boss then. Come on, Dee. It's clear you're just following orders. So who's calling the shots?
No, I'm fucking done.
You know
what? You have no right to keep me here. Fuck!
Last chance, Steve. Who are you working for?
Fuck you! You're a piece of shit, Bigby.
Beauty
was wrong about you. You're just a sick...
Beauty? You're full of shit.
Oh, we're good friends.
That's enough. I will not tolerate this savagery. You think someone was trying to kill Snow? Isn't it more like someone was trying to get back at you by killing her?
Fuck you!
What's going on down here?
What? But what? What? Really, dude? You still asleep? Wake your scary ass up.
What the hell was going on down there, Bigby?
I'm in trouble, aren't I?
Abusing a prisoner like that.
I thought you were dead, Snow.
And that makes it okay?
Well, he had answers.
I hope it was worth your time.
Okay, you're gonna have to explain this, because I'm really not getting it yet.
After our conversation in the taxi last night, I got a call from Toad. He said his son found a body. We thought it was Faith at the time. Getting her back here wasn't easy, but hopefully we'll find something on her to help us track down the killer.
I'm glad you took care of things.
Thanks.
Snow?
What is it?
I'm glad you're not dead.
Me too. I just want to get to the bottom of this. I just feel like...
What is it?
I feel responsible in a way. She looked just like me.
Yeah, she did.
And maybe that's why she was killed.
Snow, it's not your fault.
But she looked just like me. That can't be a coincidence. We just have to find out who did this. And why she was glamored to look like me. I mean... That's what it is, right? So, what's our next move?
We just keep doing what we've been doing. We do our jobs.
And I'm supposed to do what? Sit around the business office twiddling my thumbs, waiting for the big bad wolf to solve all my problems? Because that's what my job is right now.
That's not what I meant.
Well, then what did you mean? I told you, I'm tired of sitting around. I'm not going to be an errand girl for Crane anymore.
I just want you to be careful. I almost lost you once.
I'm not yours to lose.
Friend zone. Loud and clear.
I know it's dangerous, but I'm not helpless. I can take care of myself.
Got it. Friend zone. I've
been doing it for centuries. TJ is waiting inside. He was so freaked out last night, he wouldn't tell us much. Even now, he just stops talking altogether after a certain point. He's pretty shaken up, though, so try not to be too, you know...
Myself.
Yeah.
Right.
This is not gonna be easy. Why is there a rhino head there?
TJ's over there. I don't know if you want to talk to him first or after, but let me know when you're ready to see the body. I want to be there. Buffkin, do you have a second?
Of course, Miss Snow.
Of course, Miss Snow. This is going to be interesting.
Oh, that's enough. Mira, vanish! Cancel!
What the hell are you doing?
Don't even get started with me, Sheriff!
What's going on?
I saw what you did down there. Is that how you treat your prisoners? I'd be lying if I said I didn't want to give Tweedledee a good smack after what he put me through. But what you did to him was way over the bloody line. You scared the shit out of me, little boy.
And?
He saw everything!
So? Why was he watching?
Okay, Mr. Toad.
This is none of your business, Toad.
So you've got nothing to say for yourself, then? People get called in for questioning, and they get beaten to a fucking pulp?
That's enough.
I mean, I could rip your throat out and be done with it.
Mr. Toad, I deeply regret the distress this has caused you and your son. But right now, we need to carry on with the investigation. I will be happy to speak with you about your concerns later, but you must understand how urgent this is. We need to talk to TJ.
Wait, what? We? Oh, right, yeah.
This ain't over, Big B.
You know what, bruh? It never began.
TJ. It's all right. Are you ready to talk to Mr. Wolf?
Watch yourself, Big B. You do anything.
Fuck off.
It's okay.
This won't take long.
Go ahead, TJ.
I go swimming at night sometimes, in the river. I wasn't doing anything bad, I promise.
Of course you weren't.
We know you're a good kid, TJ.
You're not in trouble. Just tell me what happened.
I was there, under the big blocks, and I heard noisy feet. And when I hear that, I'm supposed to go underwater and stay real still and quiet.
That's right, son.
Then I saw... I saw the lady!
It's okay, son.
Take your time.
The lady... fell in! But... but she didn't have her head on! I thought she was gonna pull me down too! Cause she had rocks on her feet, and she kept falling down in the dark parts!
Cinder blocks tied to her ankles. Is there more, TJ?
Is it true? You know when people are lying? I heard you could do that. That's why you're the sheriff.
Ooh!
Yeah, it's my special power. I always know when people aren't telling me the truth. Is there something else you want to say?
Please, don't be mad.
What is it, TJ?
I didn't stay under the water.
What?
I know I'm supposed to, but I was scared, and I went to the top again. I couldn't help it!
I gave you very specific rules. You have to stay quiet and out of sight or bad things can happen. I've told you.
You're not in trouble.
Like Ellie's not.
Not this time, Toad.
So you didn't stay underwater.
I don't know if anyone saw me, but someone said, stop laughing. And then I was scared, and I went under for as long as I could.
Wait. You heard someone?
Yes.
Why didn't you tell us before?
I didn't want to be in trouble.
Okay, TJ.
I'm sorry. After I came up again, there was no one there. And I ran home, that's all. I promise. I want to go home.
Okay.
Go.
You can go.
Go. Go. Talking to you is giving me a headache.
Thank you, TJ.
Okay, son.
Yeah, thanks.
Come on, then.
That went about as well as I expected.
You want to go look at the body now?
In a minute.
In a minute.
When you're ready.
Alright, come on, Genie. Come on, Genie. Oh, God damn it. Alright, Mirror.
Hey, Mirror.
Hello, Bigby. Nice to see you.
You probably knew Snow was alive the whole time, didn't you?
Possibly so, but the moment has passed. You didn't rhyme, and you never asked. But as you know, I'm quite prolific, if you want me to show you someone specific.
Don't be an ass, okay? Come back here.
Where can I find Tweedledum? That piece of scum.
Well, aren't you an ugly motherfucker?
The woodsman and I were fighting. Now I want to know where he's hiding. Well, that's helpful.
Very. All right, Faith. I mean, not Faith. Snow. What is this?
So, check out anyone who fits that profile. You might start with Bluebeard.
Right away, Miss Snow.
Are you ready to examine the body now?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness, I almost forgot.
You forgot a box.
Come on.
So this is gonna be, fun. Those who have uneasy stomachs might wanna look away. Look at this wad of cash I got! Oh! Oh.
Wow. I didn't realize. I've never seen her face before now.
You gonna be okay? You don't have to stay.
I want to stay.
Okay.
I'll be fine. It's just a little strange. The glamour is so effective, it's invasive. But just do what you need to do.
Okay. That's,
That's weird. I don't wear a brooch like that.
Maybe it really belonged to her. Not part of the glamour.
Looks like something from the homelands. Bufkin, do you recognize these symbols?
No, nothing I've seen before.
Okay. It is the same cut.
Looks just like Faith's did. Did Dr. Swinehart ever get back to you about Faith?
No. He said he wanted to run more tests.
Of course he did.
If the neck wound was the same, there might be a ribbon in her mouth too.
No, there isn't.
Anything?
Nothing. So, it's not exactly the same.
Can you close her mouth?
Sure.
Thanks. Wow.
They look so identical. Why do I decide to look here?
She got your perfume right.
How would she know? How do you know what perfume I wear?
You can't fool this nose.
The nose knows.
Do you see that?
Could be a bruise.
No Okay, she's holding something, but what? Cement blocks.
Rope marks. She was tied up?
They tied cinder blocks to her ankles, so she would sink.
Oh.
Track marks.
She used Mundy drugs?
Looks that way. Pretty heavily, too. I hear they only go for the legs if they've used up the veins in their arms, or if they're trying to hide the marks. Anyway, it means it's not a perfect match to your leg, unless...
Don't be ridiculous.
Maybe she was trying to compensate with that perfume.
Wait. If the glamour is supposed to make her look like me, shouldn't it be concealing things like track marks? That brooch, too. Why would it change everything else? I've never seen one this sloppy.
It might just be failing.
Glamours don't just fail. The witches upstairs know what they're doing. That's why they cost so much. Unless someone is making glamours illegally?
It's not technically illegal, miss.
Fuck me.
Courage, for sure, but there aren't any laws specifically forbidding it.
So there's some sort of black market for glamours?
One would assume so. I imagine anyone with access to the proper books and training could theoretically produce a glamour.
Yet another thing to worry about. Black market or not, it's a pretty good match. Look at that. The buttons aren't exact either. There's an extra one here.
You're right. These buttons are wrong. I wonder...
What? Here.
Not you, Snow. It's just a body.
Well, I certainly hope you're behaving yourself up here, now that you're done smashing bottles on people. What have you found out?
I haven't finished yet.
Well, get on with it, then. We can't waste too much time here. The killer might be preparing another attack as we speak.
We should... keep going.
Her fist is clenched.
So she fought back?
No marks on the knuckles.
Oh.
Maybe she was grabbing something?
Maybe. What are you doing?
Only way to find out.
Jesus, Bigby. What is it? Flowers.
Yeah.
What is that?
She had the perfume with her. Looks like someone picked it out for her.
So, someone gave her instructions. Seen things like this before. It's definitely magic. Though witches don't usually craft objects these days.
I don't think it's wise to fool around with that. It's some kind of black market magic. Who knows what it could do? We should have it looked at. Just to make sure it isn't dangerous.
Will you keep quiet?
Huh. What?
There's something in here.
How do we open it?
I think I can figure it out. Something to do with these rings here.
here. What does that mean? Oh. Is that...
It's your hair.
Someone must have taken this from my apartment. I noticed it was missing, but I didn't think. This was the last picture I had of Rose and me. My sister and I don't talk much anymore. Who did this, Bigby?
She's a troll?
You gotta be kidding me.
Holy shit.
Well, that helps explain the glamour. Kind of. Who is she? That wasn't there before. Who do you think she is? I don't know many trolls, I'm afraid.
Should have left them all back in the homelands.
She looks like Holly.
The owner of the Trip Trap? No, she looks a little... Oh, no.
What is it?
It's not Holly, it's her sister Lily. She was reported missing, but I guess it just slipped through the cracks.
We have to go tell Holly.
Right. Who knows? She might know something about this. Who Lily was seeing.
Well, certainly another troll.
We should go.
You can't go out there.
Why not?
It's too dangerous. Someone tried to kill you. Bigby, you can't let her go out there with you.
If Snow wants to come with me, I'm not gonna stop her.
But...
We should leave now. You ready?
Yeah.
Moment of peace and quiet. It's gone now.
This whole thing is complete bullshit and always has been. I mean, what's his job, really?
To keep shit from reaching the woodlands. Jack, I don't know where they are.
You're a bar. You're supposed to have darts around.
And I normally do, but who knows where the fuck they went to after...
Come on, Holly. I need entertainment. This'll do.
Okay, I know. Just relax. I'm not here to start anything.
Hide everything, huh? Hey.
Okay.
How's the face?
Miss White! I heard you had kind of a strange morning.
It's been kind of a strange morning for everyone, I think.
Every time I see this guy, he seems to lose weight. It's amazing. It really is. He loses weight and yet somehow keeps all the muscle.
Jack.
Wolfie, my dear, how are you? Because, you know, we were just talking about you. All of us.
I'm really not in the mood right now.
Well, I was in the mood to play darts, so I guess nobody's getting what they want. I'm dying to hear about the body that came out of the East River this morning. It was a fable, right? Oh,
I do not care for you.
Tweedledee was just here.
You said it looked like Snow White.
You sure it wasn't Tweedledum?
Well, no, but he seemed pretty sure.
Crane.
Sorry.
Tweedledee said you arrested him for no earthly reason. Kept him locked in the cellar all fucking night. He said you tortured him. Which, I don't know, that seems like a breach of your legislative duties. Bigby, come on. You can't be so dumb as
Jack,
to...
Jack, find the off button, now!
What is it with you two? You and Gran are all, let's get a posse together when there's no one around. But as soon as the big bad wolf walks in, your tails go between your legs. Cat got your nerve? What happened?
What happened? I'm tired is what happened.
Tired of what?
Of trouble, Jack. I'm sick and tired of trouble. I don't want any more. So just stop revving his motor or wait outside or fuck the hell off. I don't care which.
Bigby, look. Two fables are dead. And shit, Gren's sister...
Holly's sister.
Holly's sister has been missing for what, a few days now? And we haven't heard word one about it from anyone.
Actually, have there been any updates?
I don't know how to say this to you, Holly. The woman we found in the river.
Who was it?
You know who it was.
Boy, I sure walked into that one.
If you say one more fucking thing, just one more thing. God fucking damn it. Of course, the dear princess, Snow fucking White, is all safe and sound. Where were you when we reported this weeks ago, huh? Where are you when we ever fucking need you? You'd give 1 ounce of a shit about her, about any of us. She might have been saved. She might have been cared for. She might have been...
All right, everyone. Clear out. I ain't leaving her with you. No way.
Snow, no, Snow, that's a terrible idea. Don't do that, Snow. Snow, no. Snow,
Holly,
don't.
Get the fuck out of my bar.
I knew it.
I just want. It should have been you. It should have been you, and it wasn't.
We recovered this from her personal effects. I thought you might like to have it.
I didn't know she still had this.
That was decent of you.
Gren.
Yeah?
Take off for a bit, would you?
Are you sure?
I don't know that much about her life. Honestly, we didn't talk often. She was lost here, in the city. She just got swept away by it.
Do you have any idea why she'd be glamored as Snow White?
What? Oh, God. I'm sorry. That was probably about... She was hooking to pay down debt. It ate me up to see her that way. Eventually, the only people she owed were at her work. You know, that shithole club, the Puddin' and Pie. The owner, Georgie, with all his fucking fees, it's a crock of shit. That's how they kept her under their thumb, really.
Holly, it's okay. If it's too much, we don't have to do this.
Georgie. Not the first time I've heard that name. What do you know about him?
We can just go talk to him. We've got a lead. Maybe we can take it from here.
Lily.
Thanks for everything, Holly. Is there anything we can do to...
No, I'm better off dealing with things alone. I don't need sympathy and I don't need charity.
It's not charity. It's looking out for our own.
Is she? Where is she?
She's at the business office. She's taken care of.
I'm gonna have to go down there and get her. Fuck.
Please, we can handle the funeral arrangements.
No. It's a formality with trolls.
Of course.
Okay. Good.
Let's go down to the business office and start making the necessary preparations, all right? That club?
I'll go down there now, see what I can find out from the owner.
You were good with her. I'm impressed. Really, thanks. It just made everything easier.
Thank you.
I've been practicing on my bedside manner, and I kind of destroyed the place last time, so it's the least I could do. Dum-de-dum. Thunder.
Oh, Storm. Sheriff, what a nice surprise. I'm not sure I've seen you here before.
Please hold off.
You're always welcome, of course. Is it business or pleasure?
I'm looking for someone.
Finding you someone is our specialty, but the club's closed.
Not quite what I meant.
That's too bad. I guess you'd better talk to Georgie. You're in luck. He's here. Come on. I should warn you that Georgie does not like to be bothered when he's working. And he's in kind of a mood right now.
It'll be fine. I have a way with people.
So I've heard.
Depends on what you've heard. Thank you.
Welcome to the Pudding and Pie, where we cater to the diverse tastes of the Fable community. Your pleasure is our pleasure. Your desires are our desires.
Listen, you could be in danger.
Oh, sweetie, we're all in danger.
Not that type of danger.
What do you think you're doing? You look like you're trying to take a shit. Who's gonna want that?
Nice
no
guy.
One's gonna want that.
Nice guy. Seems like a real prince.
You do have a sense of humor. That's good. Good luck.
It's your face. You have to smile. You never smile. How many times do I have to say it?
Just gonna go ahead and just...
What the fuck? Get your hand off my shit! Oh, it's you.
Howdy.
You, stay right there. Don't even think about sitting down.
Leave her alone, asshole.
Sure, whatever you say. What do you want, then? You here for a little taste? Tell you what, come back after midnight, maybe. I can hook you up. Or, knowing you, she's probably not quite your style. You'd prefer someone who can take a bit of a beating. Tell me, do you prefer a stationary target, or one that will put up a fight?
Fuck you, Georgie.
Fuck you, Georgie. It's the big bad wolf. Jesus, yes. Bigby, you're yes. So corny. I love it, though. No, seriously, I love it. Okay, all right, Sheriff. Just fucking with you. Look, I know why you're here.
Are you sure?
Listen, Sheriff. Around here, we can't afford to wait for you and your swanky pals to take an interest. We have to look out for each other. When shit happens, I hear about it. Especially if it concerns my livelihood.
In that case, I assume you knew Lily was glamour.
Of course she was, you daft git. She was a troll.
No. I mean glamour to look like another fable.
Yeah? Well, so what? Who gives a toss? People get up to all kinds of things when nobody's watching.
You know, it's illegal to impersonate another fable.
It's frowned on.
It's illegal as long as I don't like it. The 13th floor would never provide a glamour like that. It's strictly black market stuff.
Ooh, black market, is it? How exciting. This is exactly what I would expect from a thug like you. Storm in, throw around a bunch of accusations, try to scare people. But you've got fuck all to back it up. And we're all just meant to jump any time the wolf shows his teeth. It used to be something, you know. Get that out of my face.
This was part of the glamour we found on Lily's body. Take a good look. She was impersonating Snow White. Why?
You've got this all wrong. If Lily was doing a special glamour, it wasn't for me. For fuck's sake, I want that kind of heat.
Who was she doing it for, then?
She had clients, Bigby. Maybe one of them was into it. A lot of fucked up people in Fable Town.
Like who?
Try looking in the mirror. Anyway, now what to do with me? Go on, then. You're gonna hit me? Go ahead. That's what you want to do, right? Oh, no, fuck.
Whoops.
Yo, take your sad fucking face where I can't see it. Bloody bastard fucking shit. You proud of yourself, mate?
Little
proud
bit.
Of your little mess?
Kinda.
Fuck's sake. Fuck off, Hans.
Hold on a minute. Hans, is it?
Hans just cleans up and provides a little muscle when we need it. He's not gonna know anything about the girls and their clients or any of that. No one knows. Don't you get it? It's by design. Discretion is our guarantee, right? And the way we guarantee that is that no one knows anything they don't have to know, including me. I cover my eyes and take my cut. End of story.
Why not look it up?
What's that?
Isn't there a little book with all the stuff about the girls and all that written in it?
You're a fucking moron.
Show me.
There is no book. And as for you, Hans, we need to work on your communication skills and have a fairly good idea where to start.
Give me that.
Hey, that's my personal property. Sure, go ahead. Do what comes naturally.
Okay. Oops.
Tell me about the book.
You haven't got the slightest clue about anything. Hey, now! You shouldn't have messed with that. Don't even think about it. Jesus fuck!
We can keep going.
Do not touch that. You hear me? That's nothing to do with you.
Well, well, well.
Well, well, what's this? Looks like a floor safe.
I wouldn't know. It was here when we moved in. I don't have a key to it. Sheriff, will you come on? Fuck's sake, I've got to open up in a few hours. Was it good for you, Sheriff? Next time, I'm gonna have to charge you. Jesus, you're killing me! I'm begging you, I'll pay you. Oh, for fuck's sake.
We can keep doing
it. Leave it. There's nothing there for you. This is a dance club. What the hell am I supposed to do tonight while the girls are on stage? Harmonica, kazoo, whistle a happy tune? Fucking unbelievable. Bloody come on, then. Fucking trash my business over this bullshit. Protector of Fable Town, my ass. What a load of crap.
You still have your boombox. That's one
Once
thing.
Once again, don't get your hopes up. There's nothing in here that'll tell you anything. But It's a kick to the balls for me and my club, so he can be happy about that.
Stop it.
Here, this is Lily's last entry. So tell me, Georgie, who's this Mr. Smith?
Oh dear. I'm afraid it might be a fake name, Bigby. Secrecy is sort of how this all works. Even Ants knows that.
What's 207? Room number?
I don't fucking know. Millimeters, maybe?
Don't bullshit me, Georgie. This is your book, your girls.
I'm not their fucking secretary. I give them a stage, I give them music, I provide an erotic venue to attract and retain clients. But let's be clear on something. The girls make the arrangements with their clients, not me. The girls. They're the ones with the Mr. Smiths and Joneses and Mr. X types. Whatever happens outside the club, that's on them. I log the business, take my cut, and I'm out. Now, I've had quite enough of you and your bullying. Excuse me while I call your superiors to make a complaint. Hello? Business office?
Lipstick, lip gloss, compact, glitter. Faith, thanks for covering for me tonight. Let's talk before you go over to the apartment. Lily. Looks like they both saw one of Lily's clients. Been busted open. Broken open, but there isn't even a lock. Excuse me.
I heard you out there. I don't remember ever seeing you here before.
I didn't have a reason to come here before.
Yeah. You're trying to place me. They used to call me the Little Mermaid. Once upon a time. Does that help?
What do they call you now?
Whatever makes them happy. My name is Nerissa.
Well, Nerissa, I've got some questions.
Of course you do. I don't have answers. You'll have to find those yourself.
Did you see Lily last night? You know, where she went or who she was with?
We can't talk about work.
This is a murder case.
I mean can't. These lips are sealed. Discretion is our guarantee. It's how things work here.
People keep using those phrases. What does it mean? This is what I need to know about. Lily's last entry. Who's Mr. Smith? Where's room 207? I have to know.
These lips. Sheriff Wolf, would you like to make an
appointment with me.
Okay. What would I need to do?
I need 150. It's not good to be short. Wait here for a second.
Not 207?
You'll think of something.
Open arms. This is where they met.
Enjoy your stay. I hope you find what you're looking for.
I should probably repair that. If the rooms are anything like the lobby, they should cut their rates.
Want it by the hour or for the whole night?
You.
I work here, okay? I work the front desk. It's to help pay rent. So, now you know.
I know I should have told somebody, but Beast would lose his mind if you knew.
Well, your secret's safe with me, all right? Let's not make a big thing of it.
Thanks, Bigby. And thanks for covering for me last time, too.
So, what are you doing here? Oh, you have a key.
Someone else was murdered last night.
I heard.
The victim was someone who worked at the Pudding and Pie. Lily. She, come around here ever?
Oh, yes, the troll. I did see her. I mean, you know, we never really spoke, but she came off a tad intimidating.
Ever see Lily with someone here? Maybe on a job.
Sometimes, but nobody I've recognized. I haven't worked here that long, though.
How about a room register? Or someone named Mr. Smith?
That's all we get here. Smiths, Jones, or Johnsons. I think the last ones are jokes.
Ever meet a girl named Faith? Or just maybe hear that name?
I might have. I don't know. By the end of the night, it's kind of a blur with all the names. Tara, Brandy, Amber, Heather... Sorry.
Have you seen Snow White down here? Or maybe somebody glamored as her?
You know, it's funny. I did see someone who I thought looked a lot like her, but she didn't say anything when she saw me, even though she knew that I saw her. I just assumed it wasn't Snow and went about my business.
Thanks.
Wait. It'll be better if anyone sees you, that they at least see you with me, so they know that I didn't let you just wander around by yourself. 5 minutes, please.
We'll see, beauty.
Just be ready to act like I'm trying to kick you out.
That won't be hard.
Listen, Bigby. I assume you'll be filing some kind of an official report or something. Which is fine, it's just that I was wondering if I need to be in it. Do you have to mention my name? I mean, it's not like Beast would ever see your report. It's just...
Don't worry about it. The less I have to write down, the better.
Thanks. I appreciate it. Well, here we are. Which one was it?
Get health inspectors through here very often?
I don't know. What do you think?
Never sure why they have desks in a place like this.
Finding what you're looking for?
I wasn't expecting much in here.
But isn't this why you're here? Why you have the key?
No, the key was just to be sure I found the right hotel. This isn't the room Lily was using.
Oh. So, are we done now?
No. The room they met in was 207.
Door, meet boot.
You have keys to these rooms?
I thought you had a key.
Not to this one.
Hold on, Bigby. I can't just let you go into any room you want. Seriously, what if someone found out? I could get into a lot of trouble.
I could just break in the door if you prefer.
No, don't! I'll help you. Just don't break anything. Well, that's weird. This key is supposed to open every room in the building, but it's not working.
Beauty!
Ah, shit.
Beast. Oh, no.
Bigby? How could you do this to me?
No,
it's not what it looks like.
No, wait a minute.
How could you do this? We've been together through everything. I took care of you. I love-
It's not what you think. Please.
You're cheating on me! With him?
No, no,
I'm
me.
Offended.
I promise I'm not. I'm helping him, that's all.
I'll bet! I'm sure you help each other just great!
Relax, Beast. It's not what you think.
Stop lying to me! What the fuck is wrong with you? She's my wife!
Beast, listen to me! There's nothing going on! I'm
mad!
Hey!
Bastard! I guess I finally see you for who you are!
Stop! Stop
playing
it!
The wrong game
you
here,
told
dude.
Me you hadn't seen her, you fucking liar!
I don't want to hurt you, so just calm down and-
Beast!
Are you calm? Not calm!
What the hell do you think you're doing? You aren't even listening to me!
She's my wife, Bigby!
I...
boy, then get your boy.
Please go. I understand.
Okay. I tapped it. Okay, so I got it. I tapped it and pulled it, but I was wrong. Talk!
Bigby, no! Don't hurt him!
Nope. Yeah, see?
You ruined everything!
Didn't even do anything!
Shit, Bigby.
What we learned.
What have you done?
What is this? Bigby.
Look what you did to the door! You can't just act like this whenever
Stand
you-
Stand back! You don't want to see this.
Beauty, stay in the hall.
What? Why? What's going on?
I just said stay in the hall.
Don't touch anything.
Is this?
Lily met her client here. Mr. Smith, whoever he is.
And then?
Must have happened right here.
Jesus.
Last night?
Yeah.
I was on shift last night.
On shift? Beauty, what?
I'm not a prostitute, you idiot. I work the front desk.
Did you notice anything out of the ordinary? There might have been some loud noises.
I don't know. I mean, loud noises aren't out of the ordinary. I didn't hear anyone screaming or anything like that, but shouldn't I have? It just seemed like a totally normal night. How is that even possible? There's so much blood.
I'm working.
Go lock the front door. Keep people out of the hallway. I need you to be sure no one comes in here. This is a crime scene, okay?
But...
Just do what he says. I'll explain later, okay?
Yeah, you listen to your wife before you get your ass whipped again.
Bigby, what kind of a person could do something like this?
That's exactly what I'm about to try to find out.
Alright, here we go.
Do all the rooms have these same clocks with the built-in cassette player?
I think so, yes.
I don't think I remember seeing one in Tool.
I can't believe this. Where'd you get that?
Lily had it in her hand, in case there was any doubt over who died here.
Hold on, there was...
Do you smell something?
No, just apple.
Rotten to the core.
What is that?
It's a book about Snow White. Or about the Mundy version of her story, anyway.
The whole book is about her?
Yeah. Huh.
What is it?
I think the apple is part of his fantasy about Snow White. That would explain the one we found on the floor.
Oh, no. Do you think it was poisoned?
It wasn't. I'd have smelled that. I think it's just a prop. It's here because they were acting out the scene in the book.
Of course. That makes perfect sense. They were acting out the thing with her stepmother and the apple, which is really creepy when you think about it. You know, she almost died when... Why is she in a glass coffin?
This is the part where she's in a deep sleep, but they think she's dead.
Oh no. What? What is it?
I think he made up the bed to match the coffin in the picture. Flowers, too. He'd have had Lily lie down just like this.
You mean just before?
In the story, that's when someone comes to kiss her. That's our Mr. Smith.
This is just bizarre. This guy really has a thing about snow. It's like pathological.
I'm getting that feeling. Yes.
My God, that poor girl. She couldn't have known. She probably just needed the money. She could have been anyone. How did she wind up here? I mean, not exactly here, but just how does a person...
Georgie took advantage of her when she was in trouble. He's a real predator.
Yeah.
I'm not done yet.
She must have been so scared.
It's a huff and puff.
I thought you were the only one who smoked that crap brand.
Apparently not. He brought wine.
Classy.
That wine bottle looks familiar.
Maybe she didn't see it coming.
Someone's been rough with this dress. It's torn.
Oh no, she must have been wearing it. He killed her and then he took it back off?
No, there's no blood on it. It must have been torn some other time.
Oh no, there's more? What? What now?
This is the same dress as the one in the book about snow. I think Smith was dressing Lily up in it to recreate the snow from the book.
You're right. It's the same dress. It's another match to what's in the book. God, I can see the whole picture now. It all goes together like you said. This creep put that girl in a snow white dress and recreated the whole story from the book with the apple and the deep sleep and everything. You're a better detective than I thought you'd be.
Thanks.
Thank you.
So he planned it all out. He had all the details noted down. Only then, when it comes time to kiss her and wake her up.
Yeah.
I hope you're just about through. I don't really want to stay in here any longer. Stalking, it doesn't just stalk by itself. Trust me, I know about this firsthand. He'll keep trying to get closer and closer.
His stand-in for snow is gone now, so...
The next step closer. What is it?
It's Crane. Could be after you now.
Good. I am dying to get my hands on that disgusting weasel.
Really starting to like you, Sheriff. You're not afraid to be a complete bastard.
Obviously, there will have to be some changes.
Hello, Bigby.
Take care of it, Bigby, or I'll take care of it for you.
Jesus Christ, Bigby. Is that you?